Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. The former head of the army has called on the government to stop the macabre charade of threatening Northern Ireland veterans with legal action. Lord Bramall said it is absurd and grossly unfair that former British soldiers should be questioned by police over their involvement in Bloody Sunday. He accused the Police Service of Northern Ireland, PSNI, of harrying veterans, who are now in their 70s, about their actions 46 years ago. Writing in the Daily Telegraph, he said the questioning greatly abuses these hapless soldiers, who should not have been there in the first place. Lord Bramall said it is absurd and grossly unfair that former British soldiers should be questioned by police over their involvement in Bloody Sunday. He added, whatever their shortcomings, they were trying to do their duty as they thought fit in aid of the civil power, as the army has generally done most successfully over so many years. In the interests of justice, fair play and even-handedness, the government must by whatever means, put a stop at once to this macabre charade. The former army chief wrote about how he previously opposed the prosecution of British soldiers over their actions in Northern Ireland 8 years ago. He added that it would be difficult for police to gather enough evidence to bring charges against the veterans because of the length of time that has passed. Lord Bramall's comments came after it was revealed a former paratrooper is being investigated for the attempted murder of two protesters injured by falling debris during Bloody Sunday in 1972. The 76-year-old, who can be identified only as Sergeant O, was awarded a medal for bravery on the same tour of Northern Ireland 5 decades ago. But he now faces becoming the first soldier to be charged over the incident in Londonderry in which British troops killed 14 civilians. Sergeant O is one of hundreds of military veterans who face prosecution over their actions during the Troubles. The PSNI has sparked anger by re-examining every British Army killing between 1968 and 1998. Some MPs say the situation amounts to a witch hunt. The Commons Defence Committee is to launch a formal inquiry into whether veterans could be granted amnesty from prosecution. The former British Army chief is pictured at the Imperial War Museum. The investigation, which is expected to last around 6 months, could put further pressure on the government to include such a provision in any proposals addressing the legacy of the Troubles. The committee will summon high-ranking officials, including Defence Secretary Gavin Williamson, to give evidence. Speaking to the Daily Telegraph last week, Sergeant O said, "The government has mishandled this so badly. I feel very badly betrayed. It is absolutely scandalous." Sergeant O, who has suffered a major stroke, is among 18 soldiers facing possible charges over Bloody Sunday. Police began a criminal inquiry in 2012 and completed interviews with soldiers in 2016. A 12-year inquiry led by Lord Saville and costing £200 million concluded in 2010 that paratroopers had lost control, causing the deaths. In June, it was revealed a former British soldier will be prosecuted for shooting a man dead as he walked through an army checkpoint during the Troubles more than 3 decades ago. David Jonathan Holden said his finger slipped on the trigger of his heavy machine gun as his hands were wet. Following the incident in February 1988, the then 18-year-old was initially charged with the manslaughter of Aidan McCann SP, 23, only for the case to be dropped 2 years later. However, Northern Ireland's Public Prosecution Service announced in June it is to charge the former Grenadier Guardsman, now 48, for gross negligence manslaughter. The decision was criticised by Colonel Richard Kemp, a former commander in Afghanistan, who accused the government of conspiring in a vendetta against our troops. In May, Defence Minister Tobias Elwood broke ranks to demand a statute of limitations for Northern Ireland veterans, even though the government had already ruled it out. Speaking to John PNR on Radio 5 Live, he said, "I served in Northern Ireland, I was on operations, I knocked over a few milk bottles when I was there, to put it lightly. I don't want somebody knocking on my door."